Good Thursday evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to Hayes Gymnasium here on the campus of North Greenville University. We're not going to waste any time, and we're going to get things right underway, as tonight we have a preseason look at the North Greenville University men's volleyball team as they get ready for their spring start. Actually, they'll start in winter. I believe they start around the first or second week of January, but still designated as a spring sport. Tonight, they'll have the Clemson the Clemson University Tiger Men's Volleyball Club. Now, this is just a club team as the sport continues to spread throughout the Southeast. And we're going to already go back and be ready for a first serve. So we'll talk about the game tonight as it progresses, as North Greenville first shot. And there is number 13, Ben Hamshow. Middle blocker, 6'7", sophomore out of Wheaton, Illinois. Grace Sutherland, Alan Ellis with you tonight. Hamshow last year, he was a catalyst for the North Greenville Crusaders in some games.
Yeah, and just like what you were talking about, Hamshow, with the departure of Luga Vaiu in the offseason a year ago, Hamshow earned some more starting time and was originally designated off the bench, but really showed his own prowess.
Yeah, somebody was going to have to step up, and it was Hamshow as teams trade service errors there. And that was number 17, Spencer Boylan, for the Tigers. Serve in will play off the roof. Clemson off the rafter, and they won't be able to get it over. Last touch there by Noah Childs. Now here's a new face to the Crusader squad. Jackson Gilbert, number 8, sophomore from Columbus, Ohio. He's a transfer from Coker College. Listed as 6'6", and picks up the ace.
And that's some power right there on that service.
Well, let's get a second look at it here as he goes back to serve again. Now too much power on that one. Something to work on here, not only in this game, but in practice as captain of the North Greenville squad, head coach Fred Battenfield will guide his team through the offseason here. As North Greenville looking for the first point, Tigers rally it over. There we see number 2, Dustin King. He's a returning face. Tigers get a block up at the net. North Greenville sets up Hamshow, and it's hit out. No touch called, and North Greenville takes a point. One of those returning for North Greenville, we see number 2, Dustin King. He has made his way all the way up to the senior ranks, the senior from Haines City, Florida. Set up to the far side, Grayson Lawrence, another returning face for the North Greenville squad. Shorts it into the net, and Clemson has rallied up to tie it at 4. Lewis France on the serve, and North Greenville will get the point. There's Hamshow back to serve again, trims the net, and picks up the ace. Serve in from Hamshow for North Greenville. Clemson looking for the point, denied at the net. And the first call out for number 15, Matthew McManaway.
And he's going to have a lot to prove this season. His sister Katie's done fantastic for the women's team. Little sibling rivalry for the spring version. See how this goes all season.
After Clemson rallies back to tie it at 4, North Greenville on a 3-0 run now. And the service errors prevalent in the preseason scrimmage hit high and out. Serve in by the Tigers, spins off the hands of Lawrence. Dustin King will pick it up and go back to Lawrence. Lawrence hits it over. Now the Tigers on the rally, far post, off the block of McManaway. King to Silas Jenkins, and denied at the net. Number 19, Zach Roy, with the block for Clemson.
And that can be the common misconception. Just because this is a club team doesn't mean these kids don't have some talent. That's some great play at the front of the net.
North Greenville now looking to extend the lead back to 2. Matthew McManaway recording the kill, coming unblocked down the middle of the net. Serve trims the net from the left-hander, number 12, Aaron Campbell, another returner for North Greenville as McManaway. And number 6, Jake Bulldog, he's also a returner for the Crusader squad. Got to see his very unique serve as a freshman. He's had time to hone in on that, as we'll have yet to see what Bulldog can do on the serve, as it is still Campbell back. Tigers go for the setter tip over. Dustin King ready for it. Bulldog sets up for number 8. That was Gilbert, who got partially blocked. And now that one blocked off the hand of McManaway. And a point for Clemson, number 21, David Birchville. Serve in here from Birchville for the Tigers. Set up near post and into the far corner pocket. Off the hand of number 9, Grayson Lawrence.
Grayson Lawrence, another returner for this North Greenville team. Played very well last year. Be good for the North Greenville squad if he can continue up the good work.
And there is a fair amount of experience that is returning on this Crusader squad. We'll go over the names here in just a minute as Clemson will pick up the point, number 17. Spencer Boylan there again for the Tigers. For North Greenville, we mentioned Dustin King a few times already. Jake Bulldog, Silas Jenkins, Grayson Lawrence, they all return. Number 11, Kyle Brandt, we have yet to see him in, as there's a Crusader point trickling over the net. You've also got Campbell, Hamshow, and McManaway back. Those are the returners for NGU. And speaking of McManaway, here he is back to serve and out. Beyond the end line, service error against North Greenville.
North Greenville trying to kill Clemson with some power, but you got to hone it in just a little bit and keep it within the lines.
Serve in now for the Tigers, and they will return the favor. Noah Childs sends it out beyond the sideline.
Here's Jake Bulldog.
Bulldog now back to serve. A lot of high spiral on that serve. Clemson will set it up. Blocked at the net was Boylan, and that was, I believe that was Hamshow.
He's the one yelling.
And Gilbert. Well, normally that's a pretty good indication. Serve in by Bulldog. Tigers will go to the net, and Hamshow with a one-handed putback. North Greenville starting to capitalize on the Clemson miscues, and the Crusaders hold a 5-point lead. Goes to the net again, and that one is returnable by Gilbert. That they give the point to Clemson. Serve in front from the Tigers from Boylan, and that one is into the net. And that one hits the wall, never touched the floor from the hand of Gilbert.
And that's something North Greenville's going to have to hone in on. They can't have that if they want to compete in the conference.
Serving again for the Tigers. North Greenville on the rally. Bulldog setting up for Lawrence. Gets the touch. Clemson keeps it alive. They hit it over. Nice one-handed save there by number 17 as it's on the end line and in. And a point NGU. And that was Boylan coming up big defensively for the Tigers there. Number 5 playing libero tonight for Clemson, that's Ryan Jaxza. Serve in here from Hamshow, played off the roof, no such luck for Clemson as Jaxza was able to get underneath it but could not return fire.
And Hamshow's had a year to just really was thrown into a spot a year ago, had a year to just hone in on his skills and see what's going on this season for him.
And Clemson unable to rally it over. They'll push it into the net. And North Greenville takes a point up 18-11. Hamshow back to serve again. Let's watch this serve here. It's got a lot of spin on it and it pops up to the roof and another point to NGU. Hamshow has got so much steam on that one. Clemson gets underneath it, but it ricochets off the roof in such a manner they can't get back to it.
And we talked in the women's game on Tuesday how much we wanted a radar gun. I would love to have a radar gun on just how fast Ben Hamshow is hitting this.
So See, Hamshow can do it again. Yes, he can. Picks up the ace past the diving Boylan. And it's 2011, North Greenville up 9.
And Hamshow had surgery over the offseason to repair a broken ankle. So this is incredible to see what he's pulling off already this far removed from it.
Hamshow again, Clemson able to get underneath this one, but McManaway at the net doesn't run into it, stays off of it, and Clemson backed away from it, thought he was going to get a hand to it. They let it fall to the floor, North Greenville with a double-digit lead, 21-11. Hamshow starting to make a habit of it back there serving as McManaway swats at the ball and will get called for being too far over the net. Oh, reach over there by McManaway gives the serve back to Clemson. Number 24, Logan George back to serve this time for the Tigers. He's a lefty. Bulldogs setting up McManaway, that quick short set. Not gonna be missed by McManaway. And no stats being kept for this game, so roughly unofficially, McManaway with 3 kills already this set. Serve in here by Campbell. Clemson able to get underneath that setter tip over. Dustin King there to stop it. Here comes Lawrence. Past the blockers. Doug in the back just before the end line and bounced off the roof. And Clemson struggling with the roof here at Hayes.
And that's a struggle every visiting team has. Low ceiling always a factor.
23-12. North Greenville 2 away from taking a set as Campbell. Line drive serve. Popped up off the roof. Clemson plays it this time. And Libero hits it over. Bulldog will set up for Lawrence near post. Past the blockers, dug by the Tigers again. This one stays clear of the roof. McManaway, the fadeaway put back, but he got it over. Here comes North Greenville again. They try McManaway. Blocked out of bounds. And poor iPad over there. Coach Battenfield's iPad got the worst of that one as North Greenville takes its set point. 24-12. See if Campbell can put it away here. High and out. Members of the women's volleyball team for North Greenville officiating tonight. Eden Shockley watching the far side corner, having to dodge that one. Serve in by Clemson. Bulldogs setting up, looking to go McManaway. Couldn't jump up to it. And now Clemson on the rally. Tigers down the middle. Dug by Dustin King off the rafter. McManaway plays it, but out of bounds. Point to Clemson.
That's a good play laying out for it, even if it went off or not.
That was number 21. Give credit there, David Birchville. As here comes North Greenville with the setter tip over. Bulldog stopped by Jaxta. And Birchville hits it over. Bulldog was set up for down the middle, and it is in. Point NGU, and that will be the first set. Crusaders take it easily, 25-14 over the Clemson club team. So we'll switch ends of the court and go to the second set here in this preseason scrimmage. Mention that members of the North Greenville women's volleyball squad were officiating tonight's preseason scrimmage. They have a big showdown Saturday. Saturday, I can read calendars, thank you. Saturday afternoon at 5 p.m., they will be taking on Belmont Abbey in a very exciting regular season rematch that we had earlier.
Yeah, that game went to 5 sets here in Hayes Gymnasium. North Greenville battling back from a 2-0 deficit early in the game. On the other side of the bracket, however, Southern Wesleyan and Barton will face off to try and make it into the final. And honestly, any of those matchups possible right there will be incredible to see for the Conference Carolinas.
Yeah, Southern Wesleyan dynamic in their offensive firepower. They got Paige O'Connor, who leads Conference Carolinas in kills. Was Week 9 Conference Player of the Week, and Kenzie Pierce was Week 10 Conference Player of the Week for North Greenville. So, and of course, on the flip side of that, Barton's only won one game, or only lost one game, one conference game.
But North Greenville did very, very well towards the end of the season, the entire season as a whole for that record. Had 19 wins in the regular season, and then this playoff play right here really, really shows what this is going on.
That was definitely this play by Courtney Williamson, number 22, was definitely, if not a momentum changer, was definitely a game changer for North Greenville able to turn the tide in their quarterfinal matchup they had.
Just an incredible all-around effort for the North Greenville team. And just this play right here by Courtney Williamson to kick it right over the net and then ends up getting the kill at the end of the play. Really set the tone for what North Greenville is all about in this Conference Carolinas tournament on the women's side.
It's not often you see, actually, it is extremely rare that you see a foot save like that.
Ever. It's not, I can honestly only tell you of three or four times I've seen it attempted, and that's the only time I've ever seen it succeed.
And the thing was, Williamson, she wasn't right up onto the net where the ball was falling. She was a good 2 or 3 feet back, had to run up and slide underneath it and hope it would go the right way.
No, and then the awkward thing was that she had to kick it straight up like flicking a soccer ball because she almost was directly below the net to begin with and then somehow had enough of an angle on it to get it back over the net.
So North Greenville taking on Belmont Abbey, 1 versus 2 seed matchup in the South region. Winner will go ahead to the championship to take on either Barton or Southern Wesleyan.
The 1 or the 2 seed on that side of the bracket.
And all those games taking place on the campus of Barton College in Wilson, North Carolina. Starting off the second set here between Clemson and North Greenville, Ben Hamshow. Same song, second verse for Hamshow, point NGU.
Doing his best to combo Yamatamba impression right here.
Is that from Dragon Ball Z?
No, not in my house.
No. Bulldog on the serve, and he hits that one high and out. Serve in here by the Tigers, handled by King, played off the edge of the roof, and Bulldog hits it over. Now Clemson on the move. Here come the Tigers, far post, off the block, and down. Point Tigers, number 15 there. Adam Schwartz getting it. Serve in here by Clemson, short into the net for number 4, Noah Childs. And North Greenville has tied it up at 2. Serve in by Grayson Lawrence. Tigers go to the net looking for the joust. North Greenville got caught up close, and the Tigers bring it home. Number 18, Liam Pinot, getting that one. Tigers on the serve here, sideways off the side of his hand. Boylan, a little bit of awkward contact there with the ball, and North Greenville ties it back up at 3. Hamshow gets the serve. Tigers just barely able to get underneath it. Near post shot, down and in from number 19, Zach Roy. Another service error against the Tigers, just barely missing the sideline from Pinot. And we're tied at 4. Got a good matchup going on here in the second set. Campbell back to serve for NGU, low to the ground. Libero Jaksta gets underneath that. Now an early whistle and a double hit called against Clemson.
I mean, who better to officiate games than a volleyball team themselves? I wouldn't have caught that.
Campbell on the serve again for North Greenville. Tigers able to handle it. Here they come. Big block at the net by Matthew McManaway.
And McManaway is one of those dynamic players. Not only can he is his spike dangerous off the net for a kill, this man can block like it's nobody's business.
And right now, North Greenville just has the height up front. And speaking of height, that one sent high and out off the hand of Campbell. With McManaway up there on the front, well, he was up on the front line. Now he shifts back as Clemson will drop the serve in. Number 11, Kyle Brandt has checked into the game. He'll get the setup from Bulldog, goes for the punch over, misses the sideline, and Clemson ties it up at 6. North Greenville handles the serve. McManaway missed the setup. Dustin King rallied it back over. What a save there by Grayson Lawrence.
But they're going to call a carry on it.
So that will go for naught. Short serve handled by King. Bulldog will set up for Brandt. High and out. No touch. A lot of
attack errors.
A lot of celebration also erupting from the Clemson sideline. There we go, off the block. Aaron Campbell gets a point back for North Greenville.
And that's a start.
Run up serve by Brandt. They'll drop it in. Tigers on the move. Off the block of McManaway and out of bounds. Point to the Tigers, courtesy of number 21, David Birchville. Now Clemson going for the high arcing serve, and it misses the end line.
Now this will give us our first chance to see McManaway on the serve.
So McManaway drop it back to that far side corner. He'll run up and hit her in. And get it in on the line. Service ace for Matthew McManaway.
Fan club's here.
Wonder if Katie is part of that.
We'll check in later.
McManaway back for his second straight serve. Tigers get underneath it. A lot of spin on that ball as number four, Noah Childs, will push it over. Bulldog will set up far post for Lawrence, blocked and out of bounds off of Birchville, and North Greenville retakes the lead at 10-9. McManaway trims the net. The Tigers somehow able to get underneath it, but can't play it off the net. Spencer Boylan, I give credit to that. Young gentleman is doing an excellent job of handling these hot serves from Matthew McManaway. Manaway back to serve again. Boylan gets underneath it. Tigers will set up. Back to Boylan. Blocked but out of bounds off of Bulldog. And Clemson back within one. There's Birchville back to serve. Trims the net. Lawrence gets underneath it. Bulldog licking the setup. Back Lawrence's way. Light tapper over. The Tigers get one, two, but not the third hit.
Those were two reactionary hits, too. Never really had a good play on the ball to begin with.
Now, reach up play by number 18, William Pineau, could not reel it in. And the Tigers play it short. As number 17, Boylan, unable to get to it. North Greenville up by three.
Play it short, but Hamcho and Campbell were both there anyway.
Tigers on the move again. Boylan past the blockers, and he drops it in the corner. Or no, he thought he dropped it in the corner. He missed it. Bulldog now has the serve for North Greenville. Boylan handles it. Setter tip over. Light tapper will drop right for Campbell. Hamcho gets the set. Tigers with a one-handed save there, and unable to hit it over, number 15, Adam Schwartz. Had the height but not the distance. North Greenville up five. Bulldog on the serve. Set there by Childs, hit over by Boylan. North Greenville with Bulldog to Campbell, and from the near post, Campbell across the court and drops it in. When the lefty has all the court floor open like that, he will not miss as Bulldog sends it out for the service error. Childs back to serve here for Clemson. Goes to King. Bulldog dropping back to set up for Campbell. This time for the far post. Off the net, blockers, and to the floor. Point NGU up 17-11. Lawrence on the serve here for North Greenville to the net. And the Clemson setter punches it over and out of bounds. North Greenville now up 19-11. Or 18-11. Numbers. Tigers going back to the far post. Another early whistle. A double hit called against the Tigers and number 17, Spencer Boylan. Now it's 19-11. Serve in here by Lawrence. Tigers get underneath it. Now the Tigers on the move. Push past the blockers and to the floor. Spencer Boylan will make it 19-12. Service error into the net. We'll give North Greenville a point.
And that'll send Hampshire back on the serve. Been firing cannons from the back line the entire time he's been here.
Serve in here by Hampshire and the ace. Boylan has been battle tested all night. It's 21-12, North Greenville leads it. Hampshire still back to serve. High and out. Here, number 18, Pinot on the serve for Clemson. North Greenville blocked at the net as Kyle Brandt stuffed by number 15, Schwartz. 21-14 with North Greenville still up front by 7. Pinot back to serve again for the Tigers. Bulldogs setting up for Campbell, dunks it home. And North Greenville will retake the serve.
An awkward hit, too. Campbell had to reach back behind himself and just bring it in front.
And almost brought it straight down. Campbell now changing over to the far side corner here for this serve. Sends it in. Clemson reaches out for it. Set up by number 21. That's Burchful. Hit over. McManaway with the dig. Tigers retaliate. Another dig there by Campbell. Set up down the middle, and Lawrence is blocked. But it goes out of bounds off the hands of Burchful. And North Greenville will keep it 23-14.
North Greenville lucky got caught. Six men right there on the line. So the entire back half of the court was open.
Now number 5 into serve. High and out for North Greenville as there is no 5. Serve in here for the Tigers. They'll return the favor and put North Greenville at set point, 24-15. Serve in here for Kyle Brandt. Tigers get underneath it, running set up. Hit over by number 17. That was Boylan. Now McManaway, a chance to put it away. And misses the end line and keeps Clemson alive. And just barely missing, I believe that's Josie Dorn who's working the near side corner for North Greenville.
Ran for cover on that spike.
Clemson here on this serve to Brandt. Bulldog will set up McManaway down the middle, blocked. Point Clemson there, courtesy of Birchful and Boylan.
North Greenville trying to fire right off the net and just keeps getting stuffed.
Lawrence getting the dig, and now here's McManaway. He's blocked again, and that lands in bounds, and it's Boylan again. Tigers on the serve again. King, Bulldog will set up for Lawrence. Can he put it away? That one's blocked, and another point to Clemson. Attacker against North Greenville. Do we have timeouts and scrimmages? No, it won't matter here as Clemson sends it high and out. Number 19, Zach Roy, unable to keep the serve in play, and North Greenville will also take the second set. 25-19. Clemson had a good run going there towards the end. And so we'll head to the third set. Now, the way Coach Battenfield normally likes to do this game is we play a full game of full games of five sets, but a little bit different. The fifth set goes to 25 as well. So five sets, all of them going to 25 points, and we'll see if Coach Battenfield keeps the narrative the same. Taking a look at the North Greenville schedule, they will open up regular season play January 6th. On the road, that's a Saturday. Alan, can you guess where?
Ooh, that's a... Ooh, you're going to have to enlighten me, Greg.
Big Ten.
Which one?
What do you mean, which one? It's Big Ten.
No, which school?
Which school? I'm not going to tell you which school. That gives it away.
Well, I mean, you got Penn State, you got Ohio State, you got...
Well, which state is it?
I'm going to go with Ohio.
And you would be correct. North Greenville opens up the season at Ohio State in Columbus, Ohio. Now, fun fact about Ohio State. They won the NCAA Men's Volleyball National Championship. That is their, I believe that's their second as a team, or is that their third? So North Greenville will have to play the defending national champions now. The Crusaders, no stranger to this, they opened up their very first season of competition against the national defending champions at the time, Pepperdine University of California.
And they're a three-time champion. And if you want to throw this on there, back-to-back.
So the defending back-to-back national champions.
That's going to be some good experience for North Greenville to go out there, out to Columbus.
And of course, this all happens because technically there is no Division II for the NCAA. All these teams are Division I.
There is no Division II. This is, the sport itself is growing, but North Greenville competes at the same level as every other team. If you look, it's just like if you look at D1 football versus D1 basketball, whereas you have the college football playoff and the FCS system are both technically D1s, but they play separately versus what basketball does, where every team is on the same level. That's more the variety of what men's volleyball is doing with the NCAA currently.
So that's why you'll hear us mention games like we just did with Ohio State, North Greenville playing Pepperdine. That was a good series that we had. Pepperdine making a cross-country trip over a game was actually played at the Upward Star Center in Spartanburg. Then they came here to Tigerville and played.
Yep. And this is good. And this is good exposure for all of these smaller schools that have decided to add this program. A lot. The majority of the Conference Carolinas have all gotten their programs in shape, becoming one of the first conferences to, one, recognize it as a sport, but two, fully develop it as a conference.
North Greenville's first home game will be January the 9th. That's a Tuesday. They will play host to Queens University, 7 p.m. first serve, January 9th, Tuesday. That'll be the first home game for North Greenville, and we will be here with you for that one. Number 4, Noah Childs, will start us off here in the third set for Clemson. And we are underway. North Greenville on the attack first, and point to the Crusaders. Coach Battenfield getting a new rotation in here. That's number 10, Brandon Baker, freshman from South Windsor, Connecticut, one of the new faces for North Greenville. Serving here by Bulldog. Tigers looking to set it up, backward set. Libero has to get it over high and out. Also on the floor for North Greenville right now, you've got number 3, Lewis Canee, freshman from Miami, Florida. Strong dig there by the new libero in the match now for North Greenville as Clemson takes a point. That is number 1, Arland Rojba, freshman from Madison, Illinois. Bulldogs setting up. Hamshow blocked. Brandt pops it up. Rose Bubble set up and high end out off from Kinnead.
Little misplay trying to go grab the ball for the serve is ended up in the hallway behind us.
And they made the server go retrieve it himself. And the ace for Clemson, number 17, Spencer Boylan.
He's getting a laugh out of it.
Boylan on the serve again for Clemson. Bulldog pops it up, and there's a point for number 3, Kinney, getting to go off the diving defender for Clemson. Tied up at 3 here in the third set. Brandon Baker on the serve for North Greenville to go over to the Crusader side of the net. Bulldog looking to set up for Kinney, blocked. Point Clemson. Pinot, William Pinot getting that point for the Tigers. Yeah. And service error by the Tigers yet again will return the favor back to North Greenville. We'll wait for the serve from Hampshire. High and out. He serves tonight all over the place. Clemson on the serve. Rojba handles that one. Bulldog pops it up. And a big block at the net right into the hands of the awaiting Birchful for Clemson. Clemson leading by 2, and the service error will pull one back for NGU.
And I know it's early, it's preseason matchups, but this is something North Greenville needs to focus in on. Service errors, not going to be easy to overcome.
Now, right now, we have a outbreak of the service error case. Both teams trading it back and forth here. Now we have a rally going. North Greenville trying to take it. Blocked at the net. And Birchville is putting together a pretty good defensive stat line for Clemson tonight, defensively. Tigers on the serve, short into the net. And North Greenville gets one back, still down 2 to the Tigers though. Brandt on the serve for North Greenville. He'll line drive it. Libero pops it up. Clemson on the set with Childs and into the net. There goes the Tigers. North Greenville with the point. They're back within 1. Tigers trying to shy away from that side that McManaway's on right now as Brandt back to serve again. High and out.
I'll tell you right now, that's going to be strategy play for a lot of teams against this North Greenville squad. Matt McManaway has made a name for himself last year. It's only going to get better for him this year.
And again, we'll trade it back and forth here on service errors. Tigers lead 9-8 here in the third set between Clemson and North Greenville. Preseason scrimmage we've got going on here at Hayes. McManaway on the serve, pops it up off the roof, and the ace for McManaway.
And I mean, if you can't get a kill off the net right now, why not get a service ace like that?
I've also lost track of how many points the roof has tonight.
I don't think we ever started counting because it was too many.
Yeah, we did. We never officially started counting as McManaway picks up another ace. Trimmed the net and froze the Tiger libero Jacksta. North Greenville retakes the lead, 10-9. And Hanaway on the serve again. Off the light fixture and not playable by the Tigers. Off the left hand and out of bounds off Childs.
Why not make it three straight aces?
Trying to go for the full hand here. And he will beat. Oh, he got robbed of that one. Clemson did manage to get three hits to it, but it goes under the net. McManaway robbed of that fourth straight ace, but North Greenville extends the lead by three. Well, a fresh start here for McManaway as he continues to serve. Tigers to the net. Here comes Hamsho, and he's got it. One NGU.
And you can tell the guys are just having fun out there right now.
And we do have a timeout.
Those do exist.
I wasn't sure if they were going to give those for the scrimmage, so Clemson takes a timeout. Not called by Dabo Sweeney, though. North Greenville leading here in the third set, 13-9 over the Clemson club team, and no sense in taking a break as the Tigers are already back out to the court floor. McManaway still back there on the serve. Popped up, doesn't hit the roof. Tigers will go for the set. Boylan hits it over, and one official saying out, and the rest agree. It is 14-9 North Greenville.
Close one right there on the line.
McManaway still back there serving. And this one will go over the net.
Behind the pole.
Yeah, on the wrong side of the antenna, and North Greenville takes a point. And Clemson looking a little wary on that call. McManaway low to the ground, but it goes over, and nobody reaches it for North Greenville. Good play there by number 24 for the Tigers, Logan George. Ten. North Greenville leads it by five. Tigers with the serve. Short end of the net off the hand of Childs, and North Greenville gets it right back. Tigers on the move here after getting the serve. High and out. No touch called. Point NGU. Short serve back there by Jake Bulldog. Tigers will get underneath it, and now here comes Boylan high and out over on the far side. Yeah. 18-10, North Greenville leads it here on the Crusader serve. Tigers trying to end the streak. Boylan, no such luck there as Bulldog running over to get it and hit over by the Crusaders looking for that far side corner. Tigers now on the move. One-handed shot, big time dig there by Rosema. Hit over by Brandt. And out of bounds. Good little rally there by both squads. And North Greenville leads it 19-10. Tigers now on the move, and Hamsho with a block at the net. Using his height up front, nothing Clemson could do.
Hamsho at 6'7". That's a player you want at the front of your net. That's incredible play by number 13.
And North Greenville unable to rally that one back up. Brandon Baker reached out for it. Bulldog unable to get to it in time. And it's 20-11. North Greenville leads by nine. The towel's already made a couple appearances tonight. As here's the Tigers on the serve. And it is reached out for off the foot of Rojba. And the ace for the Tigers.
Tried to get out of the way, fell right where it hit him, right off the shoe.
Tried to get away from it, fell right into it. Tigers on the serve again. Rojba handles it. It goes over the net. And North Greenville taking the point there. Clemson a little too far over the net. Baker here on the serve for NGU. Tigers pop it up. Here's the set and blocked at the net. Hamsho and Brandt get the block. As number 15, that was Schwartz, almost overran the ball.
Schwartz had to pay for that one, had to make a light set over. It was blocked.
And an ace there for Baker. 23-12, North Greenville leading. Starting to see a lot of different serve from each member of the North Greenville squad. That'll be good come conference play. Backward set for the Tigers, high over the blockers. Rajba, Bulldog down the middle. Hamsho off the Tiger libero and to the back wall. And North Greenville will have set point, 24-12.
Hamsho's been working on some celebrations.
Like some NFL-style celebrations?
No, those are banned.
Those are banned? Oh. Trim the net. Tigers get it back up. And Rajba with a dig. Bulldog will set up for Brandt. Cross court and out of bounds.
And this is the same problem North Greenville ran into in the first and the second set. Excuse me. Where they reached 24, just couldn't quite get that 25 for a while.
Tigers here on the serve. Rajba forward. Bulldog backing up. Set up. And is it in? Yes. For number three, Lewis Canee, the freshman, putting the third set away. 25-13, and so Coach Bettenfield says play on. Looks like we'll do so. So this would be the end of a regular match, but here in a preseason scrimmage, so we'll continue on. Maybe. So both teams will now take their warm-ups and we'll head off to the fourth set between Clemson and North Greenville. Preseason look at the North Greenville men's volleyball squad here on the North Greenville Sports Network. Welcome back to preseason volleyball here on the North Greenville Sports Network. North Greenville taking on the Clemson club team. And hoping to get more schools interested in the sport of men's volleyball, starting to spread throughout the Southeast as we are underway here in the fourth set. North Greenville and Clemson, big block up front at the net. Lewis Canee getting the first point for the Crusaders.
Yeah, and this is giving a chance for Fred Battenfield and his coaching staff to try some different looks. Check that out. Number six, Jake Bulldog playing
libero. So Bulldog getting a test at libero here as the setter tipped over, put back by Jackson Gilbert. 6'6 sophomore, not going to let that one get by him.
North Greenville also has the benefit of a lot of height at the net.
And that's one thing they didn't have last year. They had McManaway, yes, but that was pretty much it.
Had Hamshow in a limited role.
There's Bulldog making a defensive play as well. Barrow, Kinney winds up. Clemson keeps it alive. Here come the Tigers, high and out. Also, we've had an official change. Anne-Marie Johnston looks to take the place of Eden Shockley over in that far side corner. Serve in, and the ace for Lawrence. Grayson Lawrence putting North Greenville up 4-0. Also, forgot to mention, through the first three sets, believe that is Michaela Lennon's in the official's perch on the side of the net. Tigers going for the center tip, and once again, access denied by Jackson Gilbert.
Went for the reverse center tip, too. Didn't even look to realize Jackson Gilbert was in his face and ready for that.
And was staring down at him to boot. So North Greenville starting off the fourth set here on a 5-0 run. High serve from Lawrence and out of bounds. Very exciting first point for Clemson. Tigers on the serve. Lawrence will handle it. Lawrence will go for the set, actually, and he set it up perfectly there for Brandon Baker. ...6-1, North Greenville leads it. And Gilbert into the net for the service there to give Clemson their second point. Tigers on the serve over to Dustin King, and punched over, partially blocked there. North Greenville have to reset it up for King. King trying to register a kill, and he will. There's something else you don't see every day. Dustin King going on offense.
And Coach Battenfield has a bunch of new players, a bunch of guys who've worked in different roles, and that was played off the bench, if you didn't catch that.
Yeah, that's unfortunately not an eligible player over there, and Clemson will cede the point.
But to conclude the point, Battenfield has a bunch of new guys working in different roles. Try and see if a lot of guys can play 2-3 different positions. Just really see what works best for this North Greenville squad.
Dustin King trying to pick up a second kill. Can't quite do it there as the Tigers rally it over. Gilbert to McManaway. Dug by the Tigers. They hit it up into the rafters and on the wrong side of the antenna. A good set there by, looks like number 9, Grayson Lawrence has taken over the setting duties here in this set. Serve in Baker. Tigers will go take it to the net down the middle and off the hands of Baker. Point to the Tigers. Give credit there, Birchville again. Zach Roy back in for the Tigers. Now a new libero for Clemson as well. Number 14, Ryan Fisher. Serves it into the net and gives the point to NGU. Serve in. Tigers reach out for it. They try to get it back into the field of play. It catches the antenna, and North Greenville takes a point.
And that was about 3 inches away from being a really good play for Clemson right there.
Serve in here by North Greenville, and that one missing the sideline. Well, 11-4, North Greenville leads it by 7. Tigers here on the serve. Number 7, Matthew Beach. And Matthew McManaway catching the end line on the way out to give the Crusaders a point.
Clemson got caught with 6 people in the front two-thirds of the court.
Now number 2, Dustin King has the serve. Put a little bit of forward spin on it as here come the Tigers. Blocked at the net. And who else? Jackson Gilbert. That's a scary combo. You got Jackson Gilbert 6'6 and McManaway 6'7. Both of them up front currently. King on the serve again. Clemson will pop it up. On the set, they go near post, blocked, and this time it's Grayson Lawrence and McManaway. Trying to get the point there for Clemson was number 32, who is not listed. Dustin King on the serve, Clemson into the net and to the floor. North Greenville taking that point. Just past the outstretched arms of Birchville. King going for that lob serve, trying to catch Clemson unawares. Two Tigers collide, but Clemson will get it over. Bulldog, Lawrence will set up for Gilbert. Off the block and inbounds, point NGU.
I can tell you right now, Coach Badenfield's taking notes on this front line. This is a dangerous combination at the front with Lawrence, Gilbert, and McManaway.
Serve in by King again. Tigers to the net. Here they come near post. High and out. And there is a touch. Got it off the fingertips of Lawrence. Or either calling him for a blocking here. Anyway, Clemson takes a point, but down by 11 here in the fourth set. Tigers with a new server here. That was number 22. It was also not listed. Want to give a shout out to your players, Clemson, but I don't have names with the numbers. North Greenville taking the last point here. Almost getting another ace and off the blocking fingertips of Gilbert. Routed back to King, Lawrence to Kenny. Did he get the touch?
No.
Yes, he did.
Oh, would you look at that?
Got it off the right hand of Matthew Beach. Tigers trying to rally it over in a miscommunication. Nobody going for it on the third hit. Lewis Franco set it up. Nobody reached out for it for Clemson. 19-5 North Greenville leads.
And Franco visibly frustrated with his squad right there.
Serve here by number one, Arlen Rosebaugh. And Gilbert trying to one-hand it back to Clemson. He gets rejected. Lawrence will set up for Baker. Tugged by Clemson. And it's hit back over. North Greenville will have to try again. Lawrence setting up for Gilbert a second time. Rejected at the net. Rosebaugh handles it. Lawrence to Kenny, and the Tigers again. Valiant effort defensively. Can't put the second into it, and North Greenville takes the point, 20-5.
And Battenfield applauding the effort of the Clemson squad right there. That was a good rally from both sides.
Yeah, they're number 22, very good. After checking in here in the fourth set, Tigers pass the blockers. Lawrence will set it up for Gilbert, and oh boy, that one in it in the field of play. Gilbert not missing that one. I want to wake you up in the morning.
Great, it's already 8 o'clock in the afternoon.
Hey, don't I know it. Tigers trying to catch the sideline. They do. That shot for number 21. Birchville.
Birchville, a clear leader on this North Greenville, or on this Clemson team.
Pano on the serve for the Tigers. King to Lawrence will set it up on the run and off the block. Point NGU, number 10, Baker. I'm already going to have to tell. I'm going to have to resist the Sherlock Holmes reference there on Baker Street.
Nah.
See, there you go.
You didn't resist it.
I told you. It was going to be hard.
You didn't last 5 seconds.
And here comes Gilbert. He's blocked, but on the Clemson side of the net. And North Greenville, the commanding lead here, 23-6. Well, 22. There it goes, 23-6. High spiral on the serve from Lawrence. Clemson pops it up. One-handed set. Libero will have to get it over. Bulldog will go to Lawrence. They'll fake center and go to the sideline. And that is a point on the sideline. Lewis Canee tightrope in that line. Set point for North Greenville, 24-6.
Both sides are about to get ready to serve that.
That would have been interesting as North Greenville here on set point. The Tigers first crack at it, short into the net off the hand of Birchville. And North Greenville will take the fourth set, 25-6. So we've played four sets in an hour. That's pretty good pace.
That's impressive.
So one more to go between Clemson and North Greenville. Both teams here in this tune-up scrimmage. North Greenville trying to get themselves ready for their start of the season, January the 6th. Mentioned that game will be on the road in Columbus, Ohio at the back-to-back defending national champions of Ohio State. Or excuse me, the Ohio State.
The Ohio State University.
Yeah, whatever. So four sets down, one more to go. As we close in on this preview of the North Greenville squad, we'll step away for a short break, bring back for that final set here on the North Greenville Sports Network. To the start of the fifth set here on the North Greenville Sports Network. Tune-up scrimmage against the Clemson University Tiger Club team. Coach Battenfield just coming over to the home side here in Hayes Gymnasium, thanking the probably, I'm going to go with conflicted crowd here at North Greenville of trying to decide who to cheer for. Do you go for the school you go to, or do you go for
the school you grew up pulling for?
Yeah, that either or. Coach Battenfield thanking the crowd for coming out to support these guys and all their hard work in the offseason, mentioning they go on the road to Ohio State, watch them online, then come back here on the ninth. And speaking of Coach Battenfield, he has a very strong background in the sport of volleyball. Very lucky to have him at North Greenville, here at North Greenville, and able to really built this team up from scratch. This sport only heading into the fourth season overall.
Absolutely.
No doubt about it.
Yeah, and it's incredible to see where this North Greenville program has come from in that 4 years. Men's volleyball coming in at the same time as men's and women's lacrosse here on campus in Tigerville. And just a bit of a different story. Men's volleyball, a slightly newer sport, as opposed to trying to join an established one as lacrosse has done.
Clemson will start us off here in the fifth set with a service error out of bounds. North Greenville takes the first point. North Greenville has made a history of elaborate road trips in their very young season. Last year, they went on a road trip throughout New Jersey and Connecticut, having games at the New Jersey Institute of Technology, Princeton, and Sacred Heart. You mentioned the big contest against Pepperdine.
And the Pepperdine matchup coming straight from a connection on the coaching staffs between Pepperdine and North Greenville.
So that's how strong the ties Coach Battenfield has to this sport. Set up for Aaron Campbell off the near post, and Campbell puts North Greenville up 2-1 here in the set.
Yeah.
Kyle Brandt going back to serve, also getting to see the court floor here tonight for North Green. We'll have number four, Jarvis Benito. Serving by Brandt. Clemson will set it up at the net here. They come near post, off the block. North Greenville can't keep it alive. Number 24 for Clemson, who is on the roster, Logan George, gets the point. Tigers on the serve. King pops it up. Set for Campbell, trying to get a little side spin on it and is rewarded for it. And North Greenville retakes the lead. Also a very good trend for this young North Greenville squad. Two of the three full seasons they've played, they have made the conference tournament. So they have gone to the postseason.
From the look of things so far in this scrimmage, though it's very early, North Greenville looks like they have a good chance to continue that trend.
And they were on the verge of hosting a home playoff game last year, fell a couple of games short, as here comes Ben Hamshow down the middle. North Greenville up 4-2. Benito on the serve, missing the end line for the service error. And Clemson returns a favor with a service error of their own. Campbell, he'll drop back to serve, with North Greenville up by three. Clemson pushes up to the net. They go far post, off the block, and to the floor. Gonna have to finalize the roster here for North Greenville. Still don't have that number five. Clemson on the serve, short into the net, off the hand of Zach Roy. Dustin King will line up for the serve for NGU. Clemson to the net, setting up, over to Campbell. Set up again, Hampshire down the middle.
And everyone on the Clemson side in the way of that ball just flinched and hoped that wasn't going to hit them.
King back again to serve. Clemson again, they'll try far post here, short into the net, off the hand of Franco. King back once again. To the net it goes. Hamshow trying to win the joust and will. Yeah, Hamshow's got a couple of inches up there on the net. Number four, Noah Childs, who he was going up against. And the ace there for Dustin King.
Well, the difference for Battenfield and his NCAA D1 squad is that he can recruit. This is, for the Clemson squad, this is a bunch of guys who attend the university who just want to play some volleyball.
And maybe one day they can form a team and we'll see men's volleyball down to Clemson as no touch called on that shot.
Get one of those official matchups.
North Greenville takes that point to take an 8-point lead. To the serve. Hit over by the Tigers. Number 13, Franco. And early whistle will give the point to the Tigers. A double hit called against North Greenville. Are they trying to start the wave in here?
They were. They already did it.
Impressive. Very impressive. No, they're still trying to do it.
They're trying to go all the way around now.
It'll be a little hard to do, but more power to you. Another early whistle and another point to Clemson.
Running into the net.
Tigers on the serve here, Boylan. North Greenville sets up for Hamshaw, far post. Partially blocked to the floor on the Clemson side of the net.
Hamshaw's making a case for himself to be a kill specialist here for this North Greenville team.
See what he can do here on the serve. Clemson pops it up. Set by Childs. Tigers get it over. Now Hamshaw up to the center, and North Greenville almost had a miscue there. Dustin King got it over, and now Clemson called. I believe they gone for a blocking error. ...13-5, North Greenville leads at Hamshaw back again. And trims the net and picks up the ace. Nobody was there in the in the Clemson middle part of the field, and the North Greenville bench has formed the canoe. They have begun the celebration.
That's something we noted all of last season, just how hyped the men's volleyball benches were getting.
Oh, taking a field goal, and it's good. And another ace there for Ben Hamshaw, and North Greenville calls timeout.
They're going to call the match right here.
Yep, 15. That was it. So we only played the fifth one to 15. Looks like
there was a deal at the net before the set ever began. We don't have mics on them.
So that will be it. We still play a full five sets. And North Greenville wins all five over Clemson. Good to see these guys from Clemson back up here. Like to have this matchup continue. Great experience for those guys. Also good experience for North Greenville to get to the court floor here in the offseason, see what they have, see what matchups they can present as they will start off the season again on the road at Ohio State. January the 6th, first home game will be January the 9th against Queens, and we will bring that one to you live here Tuesday night from Hayes Gymnasium. And we are off for better part of a week. Our next matchup will be, I believe, men's basketball November 16th against Piedmont International.
That it should be. It's winding down towards the end of broadcast season. Basketball's about to begin, but...
Oh, it's... Don't you ever say that. It's never the end of broadcast season.
No.
But those words don't exist.
They don't. You're right. But it's winding down. It's a little lighter here about... Volleyball's done for us until January. Basketball's about to begin, but... The North Greenville squad's playing only, I believe, three or four home matches between November and December before really hitting the road running in January.
And another thing, don't forget, North Greenville women's volleyball taken to the road to go to Barton for a semifinal matchup against Belmont Abbey.
Saturday at 5.
Barton will be taking on Southern Wesleyan. Winners from those will advance to the Conference Carolinas Championship and try to... Pick up a postseason championship and head off to the NCAA Division II tournament. Yes, you are correct on that. So I guess we shouldn't leave without at least naming a Moser Greer player of the game, even though it was a scrimmage. And yeah, I see you pointing down there to number 13, Ben Hamshaw. So Hamshaw definitely made a statement tonight, and he's going to be a force to be reckoned with come time to play for North Greenville. Also got to keep an eye on McManaway and see what some of these younger guys can do. Lewis Kinney looked good. Brandon Baker looked really good tonight. I don't believe we got to see number 17, Tyler Peach. Actually, that might have. No, he's listed as an outside hitter. Matthew Hartberger, that might have been that number 5 that wasn't on here. He's listed as a setter, so have to wait and see about that. So Ben Hamshaw, your Moser Greer player of the game, and that will wrap up this scrimmage against Clemson University. So for all of us here at the North Greenville Sports Network, we'll take some time off and come back here to Hayes for men's basketball. That's going to be a fun time to see what Coach Lister's squad can do. So for myself, Grace Littleman, for Alan Ellis, Alan Cahaley, and Jeremiah Drummond producing, this has been the North Greenville Sports Network.